VLC is often used for troubleshooting for a few simple reasons. It is free to download and use. It can be used on both Windows and Linux systems. It has the ability to display RTSP streams from cameras, and it has some additional features we can take advantage of when examining a video stream. We've mentioned in some other videos that while seeing video in a camera's web interface is a good way to see what the camera is seeing, this is not the same data your ExactVision server is connected to and recording. ExactVision records an RTSP stream, which cannot be directly displayed in a web browser. Always perform your troubleshooting steps from the system running the ExactVision server application and not from a client workstation. It is the server which is recording the video streams and the server which provides the streams to your client workstations. Let's begin by using VLC to open an RTSP stream from a camera. After opening the VLC media player, open the media menu and choose Open Network Stream. You may also use your keyboard and press Control N. In the dialog that appears, there are some examples of addresses that the program can use. Near the bottom, you see an example of an RTSP URL. You will need to know the IP address of the camera. You may already know this if it was previously connected in your ExactVision software. You could additionally use the Find IP Cameras panel on the Add IP Cameras page in your client software, or the camera manufacturer's discovery tool, or other network scanning tools. You will also need any potential subdirectory portions of the URL. Here's the tricky part. Camera manufacturers use different RTSP URL formats. Sometimes you will find a manufacturer even uses different formats between series of cameras. So how do you know what URL your camera uses? The first place to check is the camera's manual. Many cameras no longer come with printed manuals, but you should be able to locate one on the manufacturer's website. Often, they will list the RTSP URL somewhere in the manual. If they do not include this information, you will need to search online. Some sites exist which have compiled lists of these RTSP URLs across a host of brands over the years, and you will simply need to try each one to find out if one of them works. You may also find this information from forums. Then there's always the option of contacting the manufacturer's support center. In this example, we have an Illustra Pro Gen 3 camera. The manual for the camera gives us a URL of RTSP:/camera-ip:554/video-stream-id=1. Note that when troubleshooting video connections this way, many cameras often have multiple streams available. ExactVision will attempt to connect to the first stream by default. In the URL, changing the stream ID to 2 would connect to a different stream than we are interested in testing. Additionally, you will typically find each stream after the primary is provided at increasingly lower resolutions due to limitations of the hardware to provide several streams. In our VLC dialog, we enter the URL, replacing camera IP with our camera's IP address. After entering the RTSP URL, you could be prompted to enter login credentials to the camera. Whether or not you must authenticate to the RTSP stream is different for each camera, and some cameras have the option for you to decide to enable or disable this authentication. Forcing authentication to RTSP streams is a helpful way to prevent someone potentially snooping on your network from gaining access to monitor your cameras. We now have our RTSP stream open in VLC, displaying the live video from our camera. VLC is often used to help show a particular video problem is not caused by ExactVision itself. By opening the same RTSP stream seen and recorded in ExactVision, and potentially seeing the same issue, it indicates the problem lies outside of ExactVision, either with the camera itself or with the network. Click Tools from the menu and select Media Information, or press Ctrl-I. Some of the information displayed in this window relates to playback of video files, so click the Statistics tab in the window. We're not using audio here, so look at the Video Statistics section. This shows the number of blocks being decoded by VLC, as well as the number of frames being displayed. Below this, we see lost. What this can indicate is whether or not frames are getting lost across the network before they reach the system running VLC. Remember, VLC is a free and simple way to help isolate video issues with Windows, Linux, and portable versions available.